Ashley Hart, Alice by Daniel Levine, Andy by Andrew Westfall, Arthur by Lucas Heinrich, Zenobia by Alexa Paolo, Zane by Tyler Hart, Zilch by Nate Reinisch, Zero by Joe Kolesky, The Man by Dylan Heinerman. The director is Jeremy Trost and assistant director Laura Tubbs.
Come on, let's go. You were named it. How do you feel?
Good.
Like that? Phew, we're done. You guys did a really good job. When the curtains opened at the beginning, your stage was set up so nicely. It was very appealing to see. The balance was really good. I wanted to mention that because sometimes you forget to do that when you're doing a play. You forget to look from the audience's point of view, so that was really good. Volume was good. Sometimes we talked a little fast. I think nerves kicked in a little bit there. And when you talk too fast, a couple of you had that problem. I think it was more noticeable with you because you had most of the lines. You know, but when you talk too fast, it makes it harder for the audience to understand what you're saying. I was really impressed with the way you guys really tried to get into your characters, and you used inflection in your voice, so your voices went up and down like they do when you normally talk. I was really, really impressed with that. That's hard to do when you're taking on a different character, and when you do that, you have to be careful when you get down to the low part, when you're talking with highs and lows. When you get to the low part, you have to be louder. Because when we talk lower, it's very naturally a softer sound that comes out. So it was harder to hear a little bit when we get to those low spots. But it was really good to see you guys really putting yourselves into your characters. So you were getting those inflections in there. Sometimes the relationships between the characters, the checker players, and the poetry, it was a little bit hard to believe that you were having those feelings of liking each other. We're not too surprised, are we? I think, and even, because when you're in a play, sometimes you really don't like the person that you have to be with. But part of it, I think if you looked at each other more, if you actually made eye contact, that would make that more believable for the audience. The checker playing and the interactions and the lines came across very nicely, but the interaction between the two people themselves, the eye contact would have been big. Even if you didn't want to physically get closer to each other, if you actually looked at each other sometimes when you're talking, that would have helped a little bit. It was good. I really liked it. You picked a play that had a message. It was well suited to the group that you have. I really enjoyed it.
I did too. I thought it was very good. I enjoyed it immensely. A few basic things. Once in a while, we don't want to see your profile. And a couple times you did that. Lee did it very well. She was always at the audience, but that was kind of your character. Once in a while, we had, you know, when you stand, I'm talking to Diana here, I'm talking right at her. On stage, I want to kind of be looking this way, so you project out. A few times, not often. I thought it was very good. Your part was very difficult. I thought you did a wonderful job. Once in a while, I teach public speaking, and you were almost at that point. And I guess I was going to say, once in a while, when you want to emphasize, the best way to emphasize is to slow down. Now, it was very difficult, and I thought you did great. Your facial expression was good, your voice was good, we could understand every word. If I was to criticize in that area, I would have had to slow down once in a while, or work for variety in what you say. In music, you want to be right on the beat. In speaking, you probably don't. You want to vary the speed with which you speak. And the best way to emphasize something is not to talk real fast, but to talk slow and right at people. I did want to emphasize the voice in the audience. There. That was great.
That was excellent.
I have seen that done other times, and it's kind of low and not... You yelled it out, and you made me believe that you were the smart aleck out in the crowd.
Be proud of yourself. You did a really, really nice job.
Really nice job.
Those are going to go out the regular.
better?
Yeah.
Okay. I've never been told my voice wasn't loud enough before. Thank you. Be sure to announce that in my classroom on Monday. First of all, we wanted to let you know we did not award any white ribbons. No, all of you did a really, really good job, and we could not see anybody lower than a red. You should all be very proud of yourselves for that. We'll go in order that the plays were presented to let you know what color ribbon your group got. Okay. We have the Crystal Star 4-H Club with the whites of their eyes and the red ribbon.
Setting. And to me, that means a lot of preparatory work, whether it's mom, dads, or leaders, or what have you. And I think that's why we felt that there was no whites today. Everybody came fairly well prepared. I've been doing this for more years than I want to admit to, and I have seen some years when about every fifth line had to be prompted and things like that. So I think you can congratulate yourselves that you did a good job overall. So the suspense is probably now over to some degree. We have Smile a While and Buchanan Badgers, both with a blue. And the first runner-up will be Randy the Red Horn Moose. And is now very obvious. The champion went to the Buchanan Badgers with Peggy Pinkside Pirate.
choice between Diana and I. They just did a terrific job for a very young group, and I just want to express again my gratitude for letting me be here and value your children, and I just enjoyed doing it, and thank you very much.